Hey, Free Code Camp, and welcome to another daily programmer web series. And in this one, we're going to be talking about the three sum problem, which is number 323, posted on the daily programmer subreddit. Let's go ahead and break it down on the whiteboard. So the three sum problem is defined like so. Given an array or list of numbers, print out all the combinations of three numbers, which when summed up, equate to zero. So for example, if I were to try to choose -8, -7, and 5 as our first combination, when added together, do these sum up to zero? And this would be no, because we actually get -10 when we sum this up. So then we can try another combination, such as -8, 5, and 2. And when this is summed together, we are left with a -1. So again, no, this combination does not sum to zero. And then the last combination we can actually try would be -7, 5, and 2, which when summed up does give us 0. So in this particular input case, where we have -8, -7, 5, and 2, the only combination of three numbers that sum to 0 would be this combination right here. So we'd print this out to the console or return it in some type of array, and that would be our solution for that input. So that basically sums up the three sum problem. Let's go ahead and break this down further to visualize with more combinations. So let's first reduce the larger problem into something easier to understand, such as a subproblem, where how do you find all the combinations where you can pick one number and check if it sums to zero? Well, obviously we'd have to loop over all the numbers and only have one variable to keep track of our index. And for each one, we just print out the number and check if it equals zero. So I would be zero. And of course we'd increment I to get -7, we increment I again to get 5, and then we increment I one more time to get 2. So that should be obvious, right? If you wanted to check all the combinations of one number, you just have a for loop and loop over and print out the number. But now let's say you wanted to print out all the combinations where you pick two numbers. So in this case, we'd have to first keep track of I and then also keep track of J, which should be equal to I plus 1. So if we were to increment through this, we'd first print out -8, -7. We'd increment J by 1 to print out -8 and 5. Increment J again, which allows us to print out the combination -8 and 2. And then when J hits the end of the array, we go ahead and increment I by 1 and set J equal to I plus 1, which gives us -7 and 5, and then increment J again, which gives us -7 and 2. And then lastly, we're going to increment I and set J equal to I plus 1, which gives us our last combination of 5 and 2. So hopefully that makes sense. Basically, in this case, we'd have two for loops, where we have one loop that loops over I to the end of the array, and then nested inside that, we have another loop, where J is equal to I plus 1, and then we loop to the end of the array. And that will give us all the different combinations where we can pick two numbers. So then you can kind of intuitively think, well, if we need to pick three numbers for this three sum problem, we just need to add another loop, right? So again, let's work through that. So instead of just having two, we'd have an I, we'd have a J, and we have a K. So starting off, K would be J plus 1, and J is equal to I plus 1. So this would give us our first combination of -8, -7, and 5. And then we just go ahead and increment K by 1, which gives us -8, -7, and 2. And then since K has reached the end, we increment J by 1, and then set K equal to J plus 1, which gives us the combination -8, 5, and 2. And then lastly, since J has reached the last part of the array that I can get to, we need to increment I by 1, set J is equal to I plus 1, and set K is equal to J plus 1, which will give us our very last combination of -7, 5, and 2. So that's kind of how you'd work out printing out all the different combinations on paper, and then it should be intuitive of how you do that in a computer with three for loops. And then down here, you just sum them up, see if they equal to zero. And of course, the only solution that equals zero would be this last combination here. So as you add more numbers down the road, your loops would just go further and further and they print out more combinations. So let's go ahead and go to JavaScript and try to implement this logic. So after looking at the whiteboard example of how to solve this problem, it should be pretty straightforward of how to implement it, right? We talked about we're going to need three different loops for I, J, and K. And the hard part is just going to be figuring out how to initialize or where to initialize the A, J, and K at, and then how far they should loop over. So starting off, let's go ahead and write a function called threeSums. It's going to take in a parameter of numbers. And then in here, we're going to go ahead and declare an array called sets and return that, which is going to be, you know, all the different combinations we found, which do match zero. And then here, we'd have to start doing our loop. So we can say for let I is equal to zero, I less than numbers dot length minus two, because if you remember, we stopped two away from the ending of the number list. So we can increment that. And then we can declare a J, which is equal to I plus one, because we need to start one after the I. And then we can say J is less than numbers dot length minus one, because again, an example, we stopped one away from the end because K will always take that last spot. And then lastly, we can say let K is equal to J plus one, and then K is less than the numbers dot length, and then increment K. And again, because K will go all the way to the end of the array. So now that we have our three loops, what we can do here is declare three numbers. So I'll say const A is equal to numbers dot of I. I say const of B is equal to numbers of J. And then finally, const of C is equal to numbers of K. So that will give us our three numbers to make up the combination. And then lastly, we can check if A plus B plus C is equal to zero. We go ahead and push into that sets array those three numbers. So I'll just go ahead and represent that as a string here of string of A, B, and C. And then at the end, we just return our sets. So now I should be able to run this, and it should give us all the combinations which sum to zero. So one thing to point out here is that what's printed out is going to contain duplicate combinations, and that is because the set that we put in as the input has multiple numbers of the same type. So a simple check we can do to make sure that duplicates do not happen is we can say add an and for this check. So A, B, and C added together equals zero, and sets index of set is equal to negative one. And then up here I can say set is equal to that string array. And then I can push set. So one more time, we're just pulling out that string and putting it to a variable. We're checking if the array already contains that string or that set, which means index of equal to negative one, means we haven't seen it before. And then finally, we just push it into the set as we did before. So now when I run this, we get all the combinations that sum to zero, and we don't get duplicates. All right, so that wraps up the three sums problem. There's other ways to solve this, and there's actually a faster way to do this, which if you go to the subreddit, you can read about that. But for the most part, I think this is a good overview of how to write code to solve a whole like combinations problem. All right, if you like this tutorial, give us a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe to Free Code Camp below. All right, thanks for watching.